Two persons are now dead and another managed to escape unhurt following a fire of unknown origin this morning. The fire destroyed the upper flat of the Vizon Hotel and Apartments, two-storied building in Fifth Street, Alberton. The fire was quickly put under control by the Guyana Fire Service, but then the gruesome discovery was made. Those killed were identified as Maria Benemit and Marilinda Texador. The two women were trapped in the heavily grilled building and were crying out for help, according to neighbors.
After I see the smoke occurred, now I end up trying for assist because there was only young ladies alone was in there. So after I know them because them is used me, I try for assist to see what we could do. But then again, the fire truck only come and it come with couple of them on it, but four of them on it. No water, nothing, no sledgehammer, nothing for cut the grill them. Now we trying out as civilian trying to get in the place. But the smoke was affecting we. So after the smoke affecting we, now we try we best to see what we could do. And the people was there, but the fire service didn't have no things. So equipment like sledgehammer and these things, so cut the grill for go for assist the people and them seeing the people. And the people was hollering. So after then, now the fire calmed down. And like them run out of water. And then the explosion again with the fire and destroy the building.
Yeah. When the guy in the first window could have gone in the place. The yeah. Muslim with a go with a one grill the door get one grill and you know the Muslim with. And when they get the grill open, they can't even go in. They're fighting for going louvers window. Then them break none of them louvers windows. People have to go inside for break louvers window. Forget
we
the place.
Helping people and they ain't even coming and helping. They looking for run holes and all them things and people getting burned up in there.
Rickford Benjamin was one of the persons who managed to escape from the burning building, and he said he was awakened by the burning smell.
Up your smelly place. You smell a little fire. So I start check around like to see if any wire start a fire or something, you know. So after that now, when we come outside and realize what's going on, it's like time for gravel where you could gravel and run out. And in the midst of graveling now, all my money gone and misplaced. You understand? Got the confusion, everybody run in and out. Got the big man that went inside the apartment or passed away there. A piece of tragedy happened, left you sickening to inside. Yeah, you hear a howling in the next area and then the grill inside the door lock. It's got a lot of lock on the door. So it was, I don't know, the fire and the smoke. Because in the next apartment where we there, it's one way but it got walls separate. It got, even though we in the back apartment, the smoke affect we so much you can't even see anything anymore. It was just time for gravel where you could gravel and come out of the place.
Acting Fire Chief Calamity Idu said it was difficult for firefighters to get access to the building because the entire building was grilled.
We had to break the door and there was two doors, the grill door and the wood door. We had to get access into it. Upon arrival, the entire first floor was actually engulfed with smoke. As they enter, the firefighter entered the building, this is where they discover one of the body that was lying on the bed. And the other one was at the back of the building.
Firefighters and the police are on the ground conducting an investigation. Reporting for Capital News, Royston Drakes.
To promote a diversified economy, create more jobs and expand income, the PPPC government in just 1 year has invested over $50 billion in the agriculture sector. Farmers nationwide have received improved drainage and irrigation services. Thousands of seeds and seedlings distributed to foster the establishment of kitchen gardens in every home. $327 million asphaltic concrete road for Onvoa. $500 million has been allocated to develop the corn and soybean industry. And $10.5 billion invested in the Guyana Sugar Corporation, restoring jobs to hundreds of people. The PPPC government's first year in office, restoring progress and prosperity.